Today we are going to find out equation for trajectories in case of when we place charged particle in a crossed electromagnetic field. Okay, so we know that from applying Newton's second law of motion, external force which is mdv by dt is the Lorentz force. Okay, when we place charged particle in cross electromagnetic fields. Okay, now here if for studying motion, if we have applied electric field in y direction, okay, so along y direction electric field is there, and we have applied magnetic field in the z direction. Okay, so E is equal to EY j cap and vector B is BZ k cap, which is perpendicular to this plane. So here we get electric field and magnetic field perpendicular to each other. And when this charged particle with velocity vector V, okay, and we are assuming its initial velocity is zero, okay, initial velocity is zero, which means that charged particle is stationary. And if that charged particle enters with velocity vector v, okay, in this field which is perpendicular, okay, to each other, then in that case we have to find out motion, equation of motion. And we know that from Newton's second law we can write this equation. Here using this equation vector E and B, here what we will get m. Now for velocity we have three components, x, y and z. So m dv x upon dt I cap plus dvy by dt j cap plus dvz by dt k cap. Okay, on the right hand side we have q into vector e. We can write vector e as ey j cap plus q into vector v crossed with b, which is bz k cap. Okay, now call this as equation 1. We have to solve this. Okay, v cross b, cross product. So we know that vector v is vx I cap, vy j cap and vz k cap. So v cross b is determinant of I cap, j cap, k cap. Component of v is vx, vy, vz and for b 0, 0, vz. Now this is equal to I cap into, okay, so I cap into vy, bz, minus 0, minus j cap into vx bz minus 0. So put in equation 2. Okay, so this is cross product of this v cross b. So by using in equation 2, instead of q v cross b, what we will get, okay, vy bz into I cap, vy bz into I cap, okay, minus vx bz into j cap. So we can write this as, this is equal to coefficient of I cap is q vy bz. Okay, plus coefficient of j cap is q ey, and here minus vx bz j cap, and plus coefficient of k cap is 0, because on the right hand side we don't have any term of k cap. Okay, so this is again a vector equation. On the left hand side we have vectors and the right hand side we have vectors. We know that how can we solve these vector equations. We equate x component on the both sides, y component on the both sides, and z component on the both sides. So equating x, y and z components, what we will get, we get equations for x component as m dvx by dt is equal to q vy bz. Okay, so we can write dvx upon dt is equal to, okay, if you take right to m to right hand side, so q bz upon m, okay, into vy. So this is the acceleration of that charged particle along x axis. Similarly, if you equate y component, m dv by dt is equal to this. If you take this m to right hand side, so dvy by dt is equal to, okay, m or dvy by dt is equal to q ey upon m, okay, minus q bz upon m into vx. Okay, and for z term, dvz upon dt is equal to 0. Okay, so these are the three equations we get by equating x, y and z components. Okay, so again here we have this term qbz upon m, qbz upon m. Call this term as omega. Okay, so if you call this term as omega, here we get equations like this. Here omega is qbz upon m and omega is nothing but cyclotron frequency. Okay, so we have equations. So call this as equation 1, this as equation 2, and this as equation 3. Okay, so these are the again simultaneous equations, simultaneous differential equations. Okay, so x component of acceleration depends on y component of velocity, y component of acceleration depends upon x component of velocity, and z component of acceleration is 0. Okay, so to solve this simultaneous differential equations, we know that they are simple harmonic in nature. Okay, so you start with any of this equation. Suppose you start with equation 2. Okay, so if you take differentiation, so differentiating with respect to t to equation 2, we get, so derivative of this is d2vy by dt square is equal to, now q is constant, ey is constant, m is constant, so whole this term is constant, so derivative of this becomes 0, minus omega into derivative of vx, which is dvx upon dt. And from equation 1, okay, from equation 1, dvx upon dt is nothing but omega into vy. So we can put omega into vy, so this will becomes omega square. If you take that minus omega square vy to left hand side, so it will become plus omega square vy is equal to 0. So this is again linear, homogeneous, ordinary, simple harmonic differential equation in vy. These type of differential equations we have already studied in previous section, and we know that this is linear, homogeneous, ordinary differential equation which represents simple harmonic motion, and solution of this is Vy is equal to A sin omega t, which is oscillatory. Okay, and plus c1, which is constant of integration. Okay, so if at t equal to 0 sine omega t, this term is 0, that's why vy is equal to 0, that's why this constant of integration is 0. Okay, so now call this as equation 4. So using vy, instantaneous y component of velocity, we can find out vx. So use equation 4 in 1. So what we will get, dvx upon dt is equal to omega into vy, and vy is a sine omega t. So again, this is first order differential equation. By separation of variables, dvx is equal to dt. Integrating this equation, integration of dvx becomes vx is equal to a omega, both the factors are constant. Integration of sine is minus cos omega t divided by derivative of omega t is omega. Okay, plus here we have constant of integration c1. Okay, so again this omega will get cancelled. Okay, we have equation minus a cos omega t. To find c1, so at t is equal to 0, vx is equal to 0. Okay, so then c1 is equal to, see, on left hand side we have 0 and cos of 0, because at t equal to 0 this becomes 0, cos of 0 is 1, so minus a plus c1 is equal to 0. So c1 we can take a to right hand side. Okay, so using in above equation, what we will get, vx is equal to, if you put c1 is equal to a in this equation and take a common from this and this, so this becomes 1 minus cos omega t. Okay, so call this as equation 5. So equation 4 and 5 represents instantaneous x position and instantaneous y position of that charge particle. Okay, now for z component, we know that derivative of vz is 0, which means vz must be vz0, which is constant. Okay, so from using these two equations, 4 and 5, we can find out value of a. Okay, how can we find out that value? So we know that in equation 2 we have vx as well as vy. Okay, so use equation 4 and 5 in equation 2. Okay, so use equation 4 and 5 in equation 2. We get, see, on the left hand side of equation 2 we have dvy upon dt, means we have to take derivative of this with respect to t. So that becomes a derivative of sine is cos omega t. Okay, and multiply by omega is equal to, on the right hand side we have q ey upon m. Okay, and minus omega into vx. So minus omega into vx, and vx is nothing but a into 1 minus cos omega t. Okay, so if you multiply this minus a omega in this bracket, first term we get minus a omega, and second term we get plus a omega cos omega t. So a omega cos omega t, a omega cos omega t, both terms will get cancelled. Okay, and we get q ey upon m minus omega a is equal to 0. If you take this to right hand side, so q ey upon m is equal to a omega. Okay, so a is nothing but you take omega to this side, so A is q ey upon m omega. Again, by using omega is equal to q bz upon m here, okay, so then using omega is q bz upon m, so instead of omega you have to put q bz upon m, okay, so this mass will get cancelled, q will get cancelled, and we get value of A as Ey upon Bz. Okay, so using value of A in equation for Vx, okay, which is here, an equation for Vy. Okay, so we can rewrite equation 4 and 5 here. Okay, so we get Vx is equal to, instead of A we can write Ey upon Bz, okay, 1 minus cos omega t, okay, so call this as equation 6, and for Vy we can write Vy is equal to A, which is Ey upon Bz into sin omega t. Call this as equation 7. So these two equations are the instantaneous x component and y component of velocity. If you take Vx square plus Vy square, that term is not constant because velocity is increasing. Okay, now from instantaneous x position and y position we can find out instantaneous x position and y position equation for trajectories. We know that Vx is nothing but dx upon dt. Okay, so dx is nothing but Ey bz 1 minus cos omega t dt, separation of variables. Integrating this equation, so integration of dx is x, so Ey by Bz is constant, integration of dt is t minus integration of cos omega t is sin omega t upon omega, okay, and plus constant of integrations, here we called that c3. Again, to find out C3 at t is equal to 0, okay, x is equal to 0. Suppose we are starting at origin, okay, so at t equal to 0, x is equal to 0. If you put that value in this equation, on the left hand side we get x equal to 0. At t equal to 0, which means this term is 0, sin omega t means this term is 0. So C3 becomes 0. Okay, so using in above equation we get trajectory, instantaneous x position, call this as equation 8, which is Ey bz t minus sin omega t upon omega. Okay, if you multiply this with omega, okay, so this term of omega will get cancelled, and Ey omega bz omega t minus sin omega t. So this is the equation instantaneous. Okay, now similarly for instantaneous y position, we know that Vy is dy upon dt. Okay, so by separation of variables, dy is equal to Ey bz sin omega t dt. Integrating this equation, integration of dy is y, this term is constant, okay, and integration of sin is minus cos omega t divided by omega, okay, plus constant of integration c4. Now to find out that c4, at t is equal to 0, y is equal to 0, I already mentioned, we are starting at the origin. So at t equal to 0, y is equal to 0, see in this equation what that constant becomes. Y 0, left hand side becomes 0. Cos 0 is 1. So minus Ey upon omega bz. If you take that term to left hand side, so C4 is Ey upon omega bz. Okay. So you can put that constant in this equation, in above equation. So Ey omega bz. So we get equation for y as Ey omega bz from these both terms, 1 minus cos omega t. So equation 9 is instantaneous y position. Now if you take instantaneous z position, we know that this is dz by dt. So dz is vz0 into dt. Integrating this equation, integration of dz is z, vz0 is constant, plus constant of integration c5. So at t equal to 0, again z is equal to 0. Okay, so which means c5 is equal to 0. See, t equal to 0, this term becomes 0, z is equal to 0, c5 becomes 0. So z is equal to vz0 into 10, vz0 into t. This is equation number 10. So equation 8, 9, 10 represents instantaneous x position, y position and z position. Okay, if you plot x, y, z, okay, we will get trajectory. Okay, so if you plot this instantaneous x position, y position, what type of trajectory that we get? We know that this is x-axis, y-axis, z-axis, electric field is here, magnetic field is here. If you plot x, y, z, you will get trajectory like this. Okay. So now plane of this path, okay, which is cycloid. Okay. So this is cycloid path, which is perpendicular to magnetic field. See, magnetic field is along z-axis. So this is in the plane of electric field, okay, and along x-axis. So that charged particle is moving like this, but in a this way. Okay, so when we place charged particle in cross electromagnetic field, its trajectory is like this. Okay, so same equations and same phenomena we are going to study in Hall effect experiments. In Hall effect, we have N type of or P type of semiconductors. We know that in N type of semiconductor, majority charge carriers are electrons. Now, those charge carriers, if we place in a cross electromagnetic field, in that case, the path is like this. Okay, so today we stop our lecture over here. Thank you.